Hey everybody, Morris here, and if you're looking for a dissolve that looks better than those normal boring opacity changes that we all see, and you want to try something more cinematic and give it something a little more of a dramatic punch, stick around. I've got a really quick tutorial for you that's going to help you out. Okay, here we are back in After Effects, and this is what we will be making today. And let me just show you where I got this footage from. I thought this was pretty cool. It came from Pexels. And it's some really cool aerial footage there. I will leave a link in the description, and this is completely free footage to use. As usual, we start by creating a new comp, and I'm just gonna go 1920x1080, about 10 seconds. Select your footage, and you do Command or Control and forward slash, it brings it right in there. And if you look up here, you'll see that this is 4K footage. If you do Command or Control, Option, Shift, H, it will conform it to the width of the comp. And it'll put it right in there, and that way you don't have to sit around and mess with scaling. And if you hit S for scale, you'll see that it's exactly 50%, which is what you should get, because 1080 is about half of 4K. So I'm going to do Command or Control T, and I'm going to go, today I'm using Gotham Ultra Text, but you can use whatever font you want. I thought this was nice and big and bold. Try to get this to be a little evened up. But the problem is that there's just too much tension between these. Let's kind of spread this out. And so if you'll look over here at the character, you can kind of just get these kind of pulled down just a little bit where it looks a little bit better. And if you do Command or Control Shift C, and that will pre-comp it, and we'll just write text. Now the problem with pre-comping is sometimes when you begin scaling it up, you'll see a huge amount of rasterization. And so you're gonna wanna hit this collapse transformation button right here. And that looks good. And obviously we're not gonna really wanna go down or up that much to 1200. So, but it's still, if we wanna keep everything crisp and looking good. And we're on this first frame here. And if we do Function Shift right arrow, it should take you to the last frame. And let's just scale this up just a little bit more. With my text selected, I'm going to go to the ellipse tool, and we're going to be creating a mask. And so all you have to do is double click, and we have that. And then if you hit the double M, we want to turn up the feathering to about 300. We want to really get it way up there. If you go less than that, it doesn't really quite give you the look that I think that looks correct. So we're going to go out about 3 seconds or so, and then let's go back over here, and we're going to work with this mask expansion, and this just is going to change the size of the mask. And so you might want to hold down the shift and just start dragging to the left. And for me, it's somewhere in that 600 to 700 range is where we want to do this. And I don't think there's any need to do any easy ease or anything like that. And that, in addition to the scaling up, it just gives it a much more cinematic look. And you want to draw this out to 3 or 4 seconds and make that fade really long for the expansion of the mask. Another thing you can do is to go down here to Stylize and to CC Vignette. If you don't know what vignetting is, you can go over here, and let me just create a new solid, and let me apply it again, and it kind of just does a gradation around your solid or your footage or whatever. And you have to do some work with mainly the amount and the angle of view, and so you can have some of that darkness around whatever it is, your footage or your solid or your image or whatever. And that's just a really nice, it kind of gives it a slightly more dramatic look. And so we have this here. Let me go over here to this and sort of see, and it's very subtle. My recommendation when you're working with text or solids or anything like that is not to go with 100% white. That's in the hex value, that would be just pure Fs. I find that when there's a little bit of an off-white or just a tad bit of darkness to it, it kind of just gives it a cooler look. And you may find it difficult to even see what the difference is here. But if we go go over here and hit the FX and turn that off. See, there's the white and there's that. You can see a little bit of that gradation, and that's probably too much. Let me pull back on that just a little bit, because we don't want this to be completely gray. The idea is just to have a little bit of unevenness in the colors. And another thing you can do is if we hit Command or Control D, and now we have this text again, let me turn off the keyframes for the expansion here. And let's try it kind of a different way. And that would be to just simply move the mask in. And you can move it from any direction. Let's say we want to go kind of from here to the left and maybe slightly up. And I think that's kind of a neat look also. And you can do that pretty much from any direction you want. Once you have the mask created, just, you know, like I said, do whatever you want. And the cool thing about dealing with this mask and this huge amount of feathering that we have going on here is you can sort of just dynamically play with it without even really working with your keyframes, and just kind of go, what is a look that I might want to go with? Anyway, that's the end of this very short tutorial, and please like or subscribe, leave a comment below if that you found this helpful at all, and if you have any questions about this, please let me know. Thank you for watching, and have fun animating.